The wisdom in I Ching Feng Shui is the foundation of world peace. Good day to audience around the world. Welcome to professional I Ching Feng Shui TV station, Wei Xin TV station. Today is Monday, October 14th, 2019, and it's now 11:30 p.m. in Taiwan. I'm hostess Fiona Zhang Xinfang. The double ninth ritual for Wang Chan Lao Zu's commanding of Jihai Year of Chan Ji Shan Wei Xin Shen Jiao was held at the Thousand Heaven Gate Plaza of Bagua Holy City, starting from the 7th day of the 9th month to the 10th day of the 9th month of the Chinese calendar. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi instructed that the ritual serves to pray for the safety of Taiwan and world peace. The significant scriptures have been chanted to settle the hearts of the spirits from the underworld and mountain world. This ritual also expressed our gratitude to Buddha and the deities by heaven offering rite held at 5:30 in the morning of Double Ninth Festival. Masters enrolling in the PhD program presented their thesis and their social service outcome regarding the application of Wang Chan Lao Zu's I Ching Feng Shui wisdom to heaven.
On October 5th, Chan Ji Shan Wei Xin Shen Jiao launched the double nice ritual for Wang Chan Lao Zu's commanding of Jihai Year to pray for Taiwan's safety and world peace at Southern Heaven Gate Plaza of Bagua Holy City. The founder of Wei Xin Shen Jiao, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi, led the disciples to piously invited Buddhas, sages, deities to radiantly descend to the altar. In the illuminating merciful light, the Chinese ancestors, emperors, and their family spirits, the Japanese and Korean emperors and their family spirits, the rays of wars and 10 directions of Dharma realm spirits were summoned for returning to the Lotus Pond and Nine Dragons Pillar of Heavenly Heart to meet with the Mother Goddess of Japan Golden Mother. This ritual was one of the series of Jihai Year Wang Chan Lao Zu sky-mending rituals in Taiwan for spirits returning to their hearts to pray for world peace. From the lunar double second, the dragon rests its head. On the lunar double third, the heaven bestows blessings. On the lunar double fourth, the golden bell rang. On the lunar double fifth, the righteous qi revealed. On the lunar double sixth, the peace was appearing. On the lunar double seventh, old spirits returned to their hearts. On the lunar double eighth, Bagua heart achieved. And to the lunar double ninth, old spirits returned to the heart for world peace. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi gave the following instruction to the fellow cultivators.
在2020年，就已经树立中华三族儿女的荣幸，都抬头回顾中华三族儿女5000年来是多灾多难，充满了恩怨情仇的时代。 所以台湾祖师阿弥陀如来的慈悲祷教慈航，要为在台湾树立一盏世界和平灯塔，在台湾和平、台湾平安、世界永和平的法仪、宗教法仪来安顿中华民族5000年来。 15,615 当下仍然在不安的三界众生、三族儿女的心，恩怨情仇，至今都还没有 画下天下太平，啊，天下一家亲。所以王禅老祖领了天命，在台湾创立了世界新兴宗教。世界新兴宗教是以台湾平安为基础，世界和平为本愿，天下一家亲为重愿。
We hope all the spirits of the three realms could return to the lotus seat of Japan Golden Mother and achieve their Buddhahood to shed off their reincarnation and the abyss of suffering. We further pray the spiritual light illuminates throughout the Buddha world and the ascension of nine dragons stabilizes the safety of Taiwan and facilitates the everlasting peace of the world. 微信 news 八卦 Holy City.
On October 5th,The Homa Ritual Altar was established at Weixin Shenjiao Bagua Holy City, where Nine Dragons Pillar of Heavenly Heart is located. Over a total of 220,000 stamens of scripture recitation and Homa wands made of pine wood were burned 24 hours nonstop. Then, this rite had been completed on the Double Night Festival.We pray for the harmony and peace in Taiwan and the world.
On October 5th, the main altar of headquarters Chanqishan Xianfosi Temple launched the Nine Dragons Pillar of Heavenly Heart Homa Ritual. We had 48 virtuous fellows staying right beside the Nine Dragons Pillar and chanted Returning to the True Heart of Enlightenment and Liberation Scripture of Japan Golden Mother,continuously day and night. They fire the statements of addict, wand, red beans, green beans, rice, peanuts, black beans, white fungus, sandalwood chips, oatmeal, and the seven treasures together in tripod for wand, and then worshipped Chinese ancestors and the spirits from the three realms and the ten Dharma directions to pray for the world as one family, pray for safety of Taiwan,and pray for a true world peace. At noon, they set firecrackers and waited for Grand Master Hui Yuan Chanshi, leading Weixin virtuous fellows to show their tremendous sense of respect and gratitude to the heaven with the seven treasures being worshipped. Grand Master Hui Yuan Chanshi instructed that.
我们今日今时，己亥千秋，九月七日的正午时，我们叩谢天恩，供养七宝和文殊护魔棒，感谢天恩，祈求台湾平安，台湾平安，世界永和平，九龙柱的落成，由维新圣教功德基金会，这个张昌明董事。也是规划院院长来完成负责执行，也由邱慧平设计师，在辛辛苦苦大家一起奔波，把这个天命终于五千年来第一座，九龙柱，而且在37年来，诸大菩萨、诸佛菩萨。一起的护持维新圣教法轮常转，世界和平，台湾平安，台湾平安，世界才能和平。那么我们当然要感谢天恩，应该供养瑶池金母的收言宝报结晶收言真经，以及表达混莲禅师他领天命这个到今天画下一个句点在今后又要开始迈向真正台湾平安，台湾平安，世界永和平的法义和虔诚。
Then Grand Master Hui Yuan Chanshi fired the tripod for wand one by one. And virtuous fellows worship the want and statement of returning to the true heart for enlightenment and liberation scripture of Day Pond Golden Mother, and chanted him. Everyone got together praying for eliminating disasters and resolving grievance, praying for 1,000 spirits returning to their hearts, praying for invocation to prosperity and harvest, praying for safety of Taiwan, and praying for true world peace. Weixin News Headquarters, Chanjishan Xianfosi Temple.
Take a break. We will come back soon.
自即日起，
Representative construction of Wei Xin Shen Jiao, Nine Dragons Pillar of Heavenly Heart, according to Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan Shi's instruction, serves as the metallic celestial staff for world peace and harmony of Taiwan. After working day and night for 7 months and 9 past 9 a.m. of Double Night Festival,Grand Master Hun Yuan Chan Shi and his lady Shi Mu led virtuous fellows to extend gratitude to heaven at the ribbon cutting ceremony. The venue was shrouded in the lights of Buddha and packed with honorable guests. Holy music and elegant dances graced the surroundings of the Nine Dragons Pillar. Everyone was delighted at this historical moment.
The ribbon-cutting ceremony for the Nine Dragons Pillar of a Heavenly Heart was held at Changjishan Weixin Shenjiao Baogua Holy City in the morning on the 7th, joined by Grand Master Wen Yuan Chan Shi, his lady Shi Mu, and the distinguished guests. The ceremony launched at 9 past 9 a.m. with the 36 celestial dignities ribbon-cutting ritual.Which officially unveiled the Nine Dragons Pillar, or prayed for the Dharma protectors to protect all sentient beings and resolve words. The ceremony also prayed for universal kindness and eternal world peace. Wei Xin Shen Jiao Grand Master Wen Yuan Chan Shi instructions.
今日今时，己亥年九月九日。供奉王禅老祖补天功德圆满而树立了九龙柱。九龙柱是世界和平的灯塔，是易经大学将中华文化、世界人类的灵性生命融于九龙柱，九龙柱高34.8米，由维新圣教功德基金会董事规划院院长张昌明先生及台中市东南景观设计公司。邱慧平设计师相互配合而完成了世界和平灯塔34.8米。九龙柱的设计由台商在大陆彩桥工艺公司董事长李建勋的布施和各界同学们大家出钱出力来完成这一盏世界和平灯塔，在台湾由台湾迈向国际，这是维新圣教立教立校易经大学我们的宗旨，养贤蓄才，正民育德，高尚旗帜，天下太平，是台湾人民代表三族儿女大爱的 心，从这里再迈向一步，跨前一步，将中华文化道统、易经、风水和宗教三合一啊，那么导向世界各地。
Guests at the ceremony also gave congratulatory remarks on the occasion. Former Minister of Education Wu Qingji's remark.
这个九龙柱，它剪彩的意义，在跟全世界，在跟社会各界来做一个宣示，它是世界和平的灯塔，它是两岸和平的定海神针。
Principal Lin Chongming of Nanhua University.
我们共同来祈愿，在师父的领导之下，我们这座和平的灯塔九龙柱啊，能够安定民心，国家安定，社会繁荣，让促进世界和平啊早日实现。
Former Minister of Transportation 林林三，
我们希望我们完成了师父的宏愿，两岸和平，世界和平，这个明灯能照亮世界，这个愿望能顺利的达成。
Grandmaster present the calligraphy as a gift to Dharma sponsors to show appreciation of their support for the construction of the Nine Dragons Pillar. The ceremony comes to a successful end as all virtuous guests took a group photo with Grandmaster and his lady Shimu.The ceremony was followed by music and dance performance as offerings to all deities and the Buddhas. Weixin News, Nantou.
Take a break. We will come back soon. Coming up next is the latest international activity featuring Chanjishan Weixin Shenjiao.Korea's Taizun Jinli Hui convened the first Yeoju Eco Forum on October 3rd to 5th. The forum invited international eminent professor of theology John Pope and over 500 scholars and experts around the world. Director Fiona Yuanxin of Weixin Shenjiao Center for Religious Affairs delivered a speech on behalf of Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi on October 4th.There, we emphasized Weixin Shenjiao's idea of protecting the natural environment and facilitating environmental harmony, and we also introduced our unique culture of integrating Yijin Feng Shui and religion.
Director Yuanxin of Tanjishan Weixin Shenjiao of the Center for Religious Affairs led Weixin Shenjiao delegation to attend the first Yeoju Eco Forum held by the Xin Jinli Hui in Yeoju, South Korea on October 2nd.Director Yuanxin attended the ceremony to deliver a speech on behalf of the founder of Taiwan Weixin Shenjiao Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi. The first Yeoju Eco Forum was held by the Xin Jinli Hui. They commenced the opening ceremony at Sun Valley Hotel, Yeoju City, South Korea on October 3rd. There were over 100 scholars and religious friends, total over 500 people from 15 countries to attend this forum.Including the participants from Japan, Taiwan, Vietnam, China, United States, and the Republic of Korea. Ecological civilization refers to the people who follow ecological principles composed of natural society and human beings in harmony, then obtain the sum of material and spiritual achievement. Ecological civilization is not only a new stage of human civilization, but also ensures harmony between human and natural,human and human, human and society, and harmonious coexistence. Led by ecological civilization can make the society form a long-term virtuous circle and realize a sustained booming society. This time, the forum invited over 60 scholars to present their study. In the morning of October 4th, Director Yuanxin of Weixin Shenjiao of the Center for Religious Affairs,On behalf of the founder of Weixin Shenjiao Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi delivered a speech. She presented the topic, Asia Wisdom and Ecological Civilization, Weixin Shenjiao's Goal and Contribution, Yijing and Feng Shui. She pointed that Weixin Shenjiao learned from the natural principles, followed the order of heaven, and promoted the philosophy in accordance with the rules of environment and the universe. 维新圣教 not only value the harmony of human beings and geographical environment, but also address the balanced methodology of magnetic field energy of the universe. Director Yuan Xin expressed that she was very honored to be part of this virtuous community, gathering with well-known global scholars and religion leaders to exchange goals and contributions to ecological civilization. In the forum, Wei Xin Shenjiao also displays the series of books included Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan's Practice Advice, Feng Shui Study of Yang House in English version, Introduction of Wei Xin Shenjiao, Dharma Origin of Wei Xin Shenjiao in English version and Korea version. All series of books are freely available to all participants. Weixin News, the Republic of Korea.
For this week's Yijin University educational event, former Vice President of Taiwan, Mrs. Annette Liu, was awarded with the Woman World Peace Award in 2012 by Mrs. Han Hakja, founder of Women's Federation of World Peace.It's a recognition of former Vice President Liu's contribution to international women's issues. For all these years, former Vice President Liu, with the belief of respecting heaven, cherishing the earth, loving the people, has been encouraging the mass to embrace vegetarian diet, reduce consumption of bottled water. She has devoted herself to promoting her ideals of protecting our earth, mankind, and the environment. On October 3rd, former Vice President Annette Liu visited Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi and delivered the keynote speech for Virtuous Fellows of Yijin University. Let's watch the footage together.
On October 3rd, the former Vice President Liu Xiaolin visited Wei Xin Shenjiao's Yijin University.Where she met Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi, talk about our social issues and governing of country, and delivered a keynote speech to our virtuous fellows. First, the former Vice President Liu Xiaolin referred to our national tendency and pointed out how to come to an eternal neutral country. She further mentioned her philosophy of governing, aimed at national security, peace in society, communism among our people, and racial harmony. She took the name of one kind of lapis, Dalume, for example, which literally referred to China girl. Through the example, she reminded us to weigh our words and avoid racial discrimination, which may trigger ethnic conflicts.Besides, the former Vice President Liu Xiaolin emphasized the priority of fusion in three dimensions, including racial integration, reconciliation between Chinese Nationalist Party and Democratic Progressive Party, and cross-strait peace. Moreover, she pointed out lawmaking via referenda and detailed if referenda are reasonable and legal in the present phase.At last, she looked forward to seeing that we can come to a country of conscience through the security and fusion in three dimensions she mentioned above. Virtuous fellows in attendance admired the former Vice President Liu Xiaolin for her speech and had a round of applause. Weixin News, Weixin Shenjiao College.
Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi reveals the profound wisdom of Yijin Feng Shui in simple language.He integrates the art of divination, unveils the mysteries of Yijin Feng Shui in the hearts of the public, and creates a wonderful life for you and me with an authentic belief. Thank you for tuning in today. Please stay tuned at 11:30 p.m. on every Monday and 11:30 in the morning and 4 o'clock in the afternoon on every Tuesday for every week's Weixin News on Weixin TV.Wang Chan Lao Zu, bless you and your family. World peace. See you next week.